Hey guys, welcome back to Flipped Algebra 2. Now we're in trimester B, and we're going to start out with chapter 6. So the first thing that I want to go over are our squares and our cubes of numbers. So I don't think you have this in your packet, so maybe on the back of the cover page, go ahead and turn to that, and we'll just list out what the squares of our numbers are and what the cubes of our numbers are. This will be a nice list that you'll be able to reference as we go throughout the chapter. So basically, we're talking about what if you square all of our whole numbers, all of our positive integers, what do you get? So one squared we're not going to use too often, but just to have our list complete, 1 squared is equal to 1. 2 squared is 2 times 2, which is 4. 3 squared is 9, and we're just going to continue this list. Let's go all the way up to 15 squared. All right, so I went ahead and wrote those in, so make sure that you get those in your notes. Pause the video if you need to. We also want all of our cubes. Now, the cube is if you multiply a number by itself 3 times, so 1 times 1 times 1, 2 times 2 times 2, and so forth. So 1 cubed is 1. 2 cubed is 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. It's a weird looking 8. There we go. 3 cubed is 27. And then we'll just continue this list up to, let's say 10. All right, so I went ahead and filled in up to 10 cubed. 10 times 10 times 10 is 1,000. These two lists we can continue longer if needed, but that's just a good start. We're going to reference these numbers quite a bit over the chapter, so if you have them in front of you as a quick reference, the more you see them, the more familiar with them you will become. All right, so we're going to go through some examples where we are talking about the square roots of numbers. This is the type of root that you know how to take. You haven't seen anything besides a square root yet. So square root of 25 means what number squared equals 25. So the square root of 25, you probably already know this, is equal to 5. Or if you look on that list of squares that we just wrote out, you had 5 squared equals 25. Well, that means the square root of 25 is 5. Kind of goes backwards like that. All right, next we have the negative square root of 25. So what I need to point out on this one is the negative is on the outside of the square root. So that means that the negative stays on the outside. So the negative just comes over, and then we figure out what is the square root of 25. We just did that above. That's a 5. So this answer ends up being a negative 5. All right, so letter C, what makes this one a little bit different is that the negative is on the inside of the square root. So what we need to know about taking square roots of negative numbers is that you cannot do it. Kind of the thought process on that is, what number can you square to equal a 25? Well, 5 squared is 25, and you might say, well, what about negative 5? Well, anytime you square a negative number, that negative times negative turns out to be positive 25. So there is no number you can square and get a negative 25 for the answer. So there's no answer. There is no square root of negative 25. So what we do is we say that the answer is not real. There's no real number. So that's just a quick way of saying that. What we're going to get into later in this chapter are imaginary numbers. So all these real numbers we've been hearing about for years, now you're going to learn a different number, the imaginary number, to kind of compare and contrast with that. So we'll just say not real. The answer is not real. It's not a real number. All right, letter D, we have the square root of 1 over 25. So we have this property in math that tells us if you're taking the square root of a fraction, you can break this down and basically just take the square root of the top number and take the square root of the bottom number. So the square root of 1 is 1, square root of 25 is 5, and our answer is 1 over 5. All right, letter E. This one is getting into a little bit different stuff with the variables. We're taking the square root of a to the fourth. So, you know, you can think about it like, what are we squaring to get a to the fourth? Well, an a squared, if you guys remember your exponent properties, you would be multiplying those variables and you would end up with a to the fourth. So the square root of a to the fourth is a squared. We'll get more practice on that one. That one's a little bit different. All right, so on the next one, you notice there's a negative on the inside of the parentheses, and you can't take a square root of anything that's negative, so there is, the answer is not real. It's not going to be a real number. So anytime you see that with your square roots, we're going to write that as our answer. All right, so letter G, this one's a little bit trickier. Not too bad, but we just have to think about it. There's a negative inside the square root, so our instinct is to say not real, can't do it. However, this negative 5 is being squared. So if we were to simplify this, we would say negative 5 squared is a positive 25. And now it's actually the square root of a positive number, and the square root of 25 is 5. All right, letter H, the square root of 0.09. That's one you can just type right into your calculator with your square root button, and you're going to get a 0.03, which kind of makes sense because the square root of 9 is 3, so the square root of 0.09 is 0.03. All right, now we're going to take a look at our cube roots. So we can reference our cubed numbers that we wrote out at the beginning of our packet to help us with this. Cube root of 27 means what number to the third power equals 27? Well, we know that 3 times 3 times 3 is 27, so our answer is 3. Letter B, we have that negative on the outside. So when you see that, we know that we're going to do the negative first, and then we're going to say, what's the cube root of 27? Well, we just figured out that's a 3, so that answer is negative 3. All right, so our next example has a negative on the inside of the square root, or sorry, the cube root. So this is called a cube root when there's a 3 right there. So when you're taking a cube root, you can take the cube root of negative numbers. So the cube root of negative 27 is a negative 3, but let me show you why. If you take a negative 3 and you multiply it by itself 3 times, negative 3 times negative 3 is 9, times that last negative 3 gives you a negative 27. So the cube root of negative 27 is negative 3. So as we get into taking different roots of numbers, if the root you're taking is even, so a square root is the same thing as a second root, the fourth root, the sixth root, you cannot take even roots of negative numbers. So maybe that'd be a good thing just to jot down somewhere in your notes. Cannot take even roots of negative numbers. All right, so for letter D, we're taking the cube root of 10 to the 6th power. So I'm going to show you guys kind of a little shortcut that's going to come in handy on problems like this. You can see that we're taking the cube root. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that 10 to the 6th. That's 10 sixes, right? I'm sorry, 6 tens. And I'm going to group them into 3s. So here's 3 of them. Here's 3 of them. So it's the same thing as saying 10 to the third power times 10 to the third power. Well, how many 10 to the third powers do we have? Or how many groups of 3 do we have? 2 of them. Our final answer is going to be 10 squared. But here's why. This is a cube root. I forgot to write that. I can break this up. The cube root of 10 to the third times the cube root of 10 to the third. The cube root of 10 to the third, anytime that you're taking the same root as the exponent, it's kind of like they cancel each other out. That's just a little shortcut way to think about it. So that becomes a 10. Over here, this becomes a 10. And that's how we're getting our 10 squared for our answer, or 100. We will definitely have more practice with that. So if that seemed a little bit weird, oh, look at that, letter F, we're going to do it there. Oh, we're going to do it on E a little bit too. All right, so on E, we have the cube root of 10 to the negative 9. Well, we don't deal with negative exponents. Remember, we're going to turn that into a fraction, 1 over 10 to the positive 9th power. And anytime you are taking a radical or a cube root of a fraction, you can break it up. So we're going to do the cube root of 1 over the cube root of 10 to the 9th. Now we have that positive exponent we can work with. Well, the cube root of 1 is just 1. And the cube root of 10 to the 9th. So what you want to think about is you have 9 tens. Well, how many groups of 3 fit into that? And you would say, oh, or there's 3 groups of 3. So that is going to be 10 to the 3rd power. So our answer is 1 over 10 to the 3rd power. Or we would say that's the same thing as 1 over 1,000. Just like up here, that's the same thing as 100. All right, are we having fun yet? All right, the cube root of x to the 9th power. So we're taking the cube root of 9 x's. So this one I'll just write out to go over it again. So I just wrote out 9 x's. Because we're taking the cube root, how many groups of 3 do we have? 1, 2, 3. So that means that our answer is x to the 3rd power. The 3 groups is going to tell you what your exponent is in your final answer. All right, last one here. We have the cube root of x, the cube root of a negative x to the 6. Well, you can take the cube root of a negative number. It just means your answer is going to be negative. So I'm going to put that down. And then we have x to the 6th. So how many groups of 3 can you fit into 6? There's 2 of them. So x squared. All right, so now we're going to look at nth roots. Nth roots just means that the root you're taking could be something other than a 2 or a 3. Maybe it's different than a square root or a cube root. So this first example says to take the 4th root of 81. So what we're trying to figure out is what number raised to the 4th power equals 81. And you can go through your head and try to think of it. Is it 1? 1 times 1 times 1 times 1. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. And as you kind of get through that, you're eventually going to see that the 4th root of 81 is equal to 3. Because 3 to the 4th power is 81. All right, next example, we're taking the 4th root of a negative number. Now remember, we wrote down in our notes that you can't take an even root of a negative number, so this answer is not real. All right, the 5th root of 32, so some number to the 5th power equals 32. Well, it can't be a very big number, you know, 5 times, because you're multiplying it 5 times with this exponent. So, and start at the beginning, it's not going to be 1, so 2 times 2, if you multiply 2 5 times, do you get 32? And you will figure out that, yes, you do. So the 5th root of 32 is 2. All right, this next one, it's the 5th root of a negative number, so can you take odd roots of negative numbers? Yes, you can. It just means your answer will be negative. So it's going to be a negative, and then what's the 5th root of 32? 2. So our answer is a negative 2. Letter E, we're taking an even root of a negative number. Can't do it, so our answer is not real. So make sure you look out for those. All right, the 6th root of a to the 6. So how many groups of 6 can we fit in a to the 6? Well, just 1. So it's a to the 1st power, or j. just A. Seventh root of a negative 1. Can you take an odd root of a negative number? Yes, you can. It just means your answer is negative. And then what's the seventh root of 1? Well, any root of 1 is just going to be 1. So that answer is negative 1. All right, for this chapter, and maybe it'll be more than a chapter, we'll see, of Name That Tune, I thought I would take you guys back into my concert history. So this song that I'm going to play for you guys is from the very first concert I went to in sixth grade with my family. And I can tell you, as much as I love concerts, when I was in sixth grade, I did not want to go to this concert. But I'm sure it was great. This was my favorite song by the singer, so at least I enjoyed one song of the show. So let me know if you recognize the song and know the artist.
Just another day.